What's up you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Mina, I make videos every Fridays, and today's video is going to be my April favorite. We're just gonna get started. I have a couple of things we're gonna talk about that I've been enjoying so far, and yeah, let's get started. So we're gonna talk about body care first, and the first thing that I've really been enjoying is the Body Shop Mango Softening Body Butter. This is what it looks like. This is the tub, and this is my monstrous ass using it. This is a very, very good scent for summertime. It's very, very fresh, very like summer hot day inside when there's like AC and you're eating like mango ice cream or mango like gelato, something like that. It smells very, very, very fresh, like very good for you. It doesn't like smell too severe of mango or anything. I believe it has a little bit of vanilla in it. Do they have the notes back here? They don't really have the notes, but I think it's just mango, honestly. It just smells amazing. It makes me feel good. It definitely softens my skin. I've definitely felt a difference with this. It's a little bit more on the expensive side. I don't remember how much it was, but I bought it forever ago and I just started using it and I love it so, so much. I just really like it. It's cruelty free and vegan, 100% vegan. Yeah, I definitely recommend this. They have a lot of different scents of this, so I will be purchasing more. They have very summery scents and they also have very wintry or fally scents. Next thing I have here is the only skincare item that I will be talking about in this video, and it's the Carbon Theory Charcoal and Tea Tree Oil Breakout Control Facial Exfoliating Scrub. That's a lot. This is what it looks like. It just comes in a little pouch, like a Capri Sun, basically. It comes like a Capri Sun, and it is black. So this is what it looks like. I don't know if you could tell. It's because of the charcoal that it looks like that. But yeah, and it is cruelty free and 100% vegan, I believe I've read. Yeah, vegan, cruelty free, made in the UK. It's lab formulated with citric acid, and it's supposed to detoxify and clear clogged pores and balances and brightens the complexion. I've never really tried this brand before until this, and I really like it. It's super gentle, so it's not gonna like strip your skin or like cause like abrasions or whatever. It has tea tree oil, which is very known for like if you have breakouts or anything, it helps with that. I used to like use it as like a spot thing, like a drying lotion type of thing. If you like the Mario Badescu drying lotion, it's kind of similar to that but in a scrub form, and it's super nice. I really, really like it, and it's definitely helped me keep my skin clear even when Mother Nature is about to come knocking on my door, you know. This has been very good for that, and yeah, it's really, really good. The citric acid is supposed to help you remove dead skin, and it helps you with clogged pores, which I've definitely noticed that. And the tea tree oil is obviously, it helps reduce the inflammation of whatever like pimples you have or breakouts, and the charcoal just is good for detoxifying, whether it be for your teeth or for your skin. So this is very, very good. I really like it. It looks like it kind of has mostly natural ingredients, which is really, really good. Then the only makeup product that I have is actually on my face right now, or on my lips, and it's the Glossier Play Vanilla Lip in the shade Casino, which is this orange shade right here. Let me show it for you. This is my favorite like lip color for summer. You could use it like this, where it's like kind of blurred out and it kind of looks soft and it's like a lip stain almost, or you could build it up to where it's like super severe and super orangey, so like that. And it's very buildable. It doesn't move, it doesn't budge at all, which is something I really like. I'm wearing it on my lips right now, and I'm just like kind of in the middle of super intense, super crazy orange lip, or this is very good color for summer. I really like this formula. It's obviously cruelty free. Glossier is one of my favorite brands, but it has a spongy tip, so this is what it looks like. It's just a sponge and you can blend out with it, and it's really, really nice. I've been wearing this lip for like 2 years now. Every time summer or spring comes around and I really want like bright lip color, this is what I would go for. And if you like orange lips, I think this is a great way to go, because you can build it up or you can have it as a lip stain and it lasts you forever. And they have very, very, very different shades in this range as well. TV and movie favorites. So the first movie favorite that I really have, and the only one, the only movie documentary thing that I have that I will be talking about today, is the Demi Lovato documentary called Dancing with the Devil, I believe. And she's releasing that on YouTube, and it's really, really good. It's one of the best documentaries I've ever seen. I really enjoy it. I enjoy watching it. It comes out every week if you don't have, I believe, YouTube Premium, which I don't, and I'm not about to get it. So I look forward for the new episodes to come out every week. And she's just talking about her overdose, what she was going through with her old management, with her old team. I think her story is super interesting, just so interesting to look into what happened and how she almost died and her point of view on all of it, since everybody else's point of view has been out there. So I think it's really interesting, it's really well done, it's really well filmed, and she's very honest, and I'm kind of afraid to really trust it because she's posted like so many different documentaries where she was like, I'm clean now, and then she would come out a year later and be like, actually, I was on cocaine during that and I'm clean now. And now I'm like, I don't know whether to trust it or not, or if she's actually sober or not, or if she's drinking or whatnot. I just hope she stays safe and doesn't go through a near-death experience again, because it would be very sad to lose another famous person to addiction. And she just is very honest with her story and addiction, and I think it's necessary to be talking about topics like that, because they're people who are addicted to something are always, or even drugs or drinking or whatever, they're always so misjudged and is like, just quit. And Demi actually just shows you in this documentary that you can't just quit. It basically has a hold on you and you can't get out of it. And then an honorary mention is Friends, the TV show. I just finished it over the last month and I really enjoyed it. I watched all 10 seasons all over again because I've only seen up to season 6 before, and this was my first time watching it all the way through, and I really love it. It became one of my comfort shows immediately. I love the characters so much. They're like a family to me, and I just love them, and I love their friendship and the story and the character development, although I will be upset because one of them didn't get what I wanted them to get, but it's fine. And yeah, I really, really enjoy it. And then the last TV favorite that I will be talking about is Bridgerton. None other than freaking Bridgerton. So I went into Bridgerton because I finished Friends and I wanted something quick to watch before I jumped into another like super long show. And I wanted something fun, easy to watch, and relatively new because I've been rewatching old shows forever. So I went into Bridgerton and I went into it expecting 10 episodes, and then I was shocked to learn that there was only 8 after I got to the 6th episode. And let me tell you, I died over that show. There are a couple of scenes that have me rolling on the floor. I love angst. I love like arguments, like I want to be with you but I can't be with you because of this, and then a fight happens and they're like, I can't do it because I love you, and I'm like, that's like one of my favorite tropes of all time. So when I got that in Bridgerton, I was more than happy, to say the least. And yeah, I love the characters. I love how much it looks so realistic, and I kind of like, really, when I was watching it, I was really in it. Like I wouldn't even be able like to, like I'd finish the episodes and be like, huh. I felt like I was in it with them and with the characters, and I love the characters so much. I love the romance so much. It's trashy romance, but I'm here for it. It's not like groundbreaking, legendary type of TV show. It's a like trashy YA, not really type of TV show. It's very rated R, very rated R. There's like some hella explicit scenes in there, so definitely watch it on your own risk. But I really enjoyed it and I finished it in a week, so you know. And chef's kiss. I love Simon and I wish he would return for season 2, and I'm so upset that he's not, but you know, I probably won't be returning for season 2 either, let's be honest. So I ordered these off of AliExpress. If you don't know what AliExpress is, it's basically a cheap Asian market where you can buy literally everything. It's kind of like Wish, but I trust it more than I do Wish, because I don't know. So I bought these stickers off of them, and they're by the brand Swatelier. I'm not really sure. It's a Korean brand from what I know. And I bought 6 sheets, and I love them so much, so I'm gonna show you them. This is the first one, and this is what it looks like. These are just a bunch of stickers. And this one is the Cafe Blue, number 1108. This one is the daily stickers, and it's number 1061. This is one of my favorites. I love this one so much. It's so cute. So like if you journal, these are so good for that. Then this one is the Sea Animals, number 1071. And it's so cute. I love this one so much. It just has a bunch of seals and sea things. Sea Animals, as the name suggests. This one is number 1104 and it's Vlog Home, and it's one of my favorites. There's a lady doing yoga in it, and it's so cute. So, so cute. I think this one is her doing yoga. So adorable. I love these stickers so much. This one is food trip number 3 and it's 1109 and it just has a bunch of food items. So cute. I love it. And this one is food trip number 2 and it's number 1091. And it's the last one. So it just has a bunch of food items. Look at the sushi, so cute. And I just got a bunch of these off of AliExpress. If you type in Swatelier on AliExpress, a bunch of these will show up. And I think the most expensive one was probably like $1.90, $1.70. And I don't mind paying that for stickers. I love stickers. I'm a child, so I don't mind paying that much for them. And I just, they make me so happy. And I'm so glad I purchased those. And I'm so excited to use them, even though I probably won't ever be able to get myself to use them. But yeah, I just love these so much. I can't even pick a favorite because I just love them. I just love them so much. So yeah, that's that. That's the one miscellaneous favorite I have. And then on to music. So I have 2 songs for this month that I've been listening to. And the first one is Water by Kehlani. And I just listened to her album. It was good until it wasn't. And it's not impressive for me, but this one is one of my favorites. And it's so cute. And the next one that I've really been enjoying is We're Good by Dua Lipa. It's kind of a silly radio pop-y song, but it's pretty fun to sing along to and it's pretty funny, so. The one that I've been listening to on repeat, literally non-stop, for the past like 2 weeks, and it is Slide by Chase Atlantic. Chase Atlantic is really there for the Wattpad bitches. I am one of them, and this song slaps. But yeah, that is it for this video. That is my favorites for the month of April. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know down below what are some things you've been enjoying this past month. I look forward to reading them. Give this video a thumbs up if you want more monthly favorites because I love filming these. They're one of my favorite videos to film. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day. Always remember to keep your head, heels, and standards high and to treat people with kindness. And I will see you guys again next week with another video. Bye, you guys.